Next up for Jimmy Akin is a Facebook question from Stephen. And Stephen says, well, in essence, he boils it right down and then puts some other details to his question here. He says, how many people will be saved, Jimmy? He says, St. Augustine, St. Jerome, St. John Chrysostom all taught that few will be saved. St. Leonard of Port Maurice, in a sermon entitled The Little Number of Those Who Are Saved, spoke pretty devastatingly of the fewness of the saved. Alternatively, some modern voices skew toward the other end of the spectrum. The doctors of the church don't leave much hope for the vast number of humanity. What do you think, and what does the church teach on this?
The church doesn't have a particular teaching on the number of the saved. You won't find that in magisterial documents, especially not in contemporary ones. There are passages in the New Testament that make it sound like the number of the saved will be few. In fact, at one point, Jesus is asked, will those who are saved be few? And he responds by saying that we should seek the narrow way, because many are those who find the road, who take the road to destruction, and few are those who find and take the road to life. So when he's contrasting the many and the few, in the context of being asked, will many be saved or will few be saved, that suggests that it's going to be few, so something less than 50%, and perhaps considerably less than 50%. But there's a question about who are we talking about here and when are we talking about? Because the ancient world in some ways was a very different place than the one we live in now. The number of people who worshipped the God of Israel at that time, which is to say the true God, was vanishingly small. You know, there were a few million Jews in the world and, you know, a smaller number of Gentiles that also worshipped God, but it was still a very small number of people. Whereas today, a third of the human race is Christian, and half of the human race worships the true God. So you've got a very different situation today than you did back then, and it's not clear that Jesus was addressing all of history in his remark. He presumably was speaking of his own day. And so in his own day, yeah, it could well be that few people were saved, but it could also be that there's reason for greater optimism in our day. There are also passages in the New Testament that indicate a large number of people will be saved. If you look, for example, in the book of Revelation, at one point John sees, and what he says is, an innumerable multitude from every nation and tribe and tongue that are worshiping and praising God in heaven. And so there you've got an innumerable multitude. Now, he doesn't give us a fraction, but he indicates it's a very, very, very large number of people who are saved that he's seeing in heaven. So it depends on which passage you're looking at, and it depends on when in history these passages are intended to apply. There was a study of this question that was done by the late Cardinal Avery Dulles. It's found in the journal First Things, and it's available online. But if you look it up, just type in Avery Dulles, Hell, First Things, you should come across it. And he concludes that ultimately God hasn't told us the exact numbers or ratios, that we can't confidently establish them. And he says he thinks that's a good thing, because if we knew for a fact that in our age very few people would be saved, we'd be inclined to despair, and that would be bad. It would lead us to not pursue our salvation. On the other hand, if we knew a large majority of people would be saved in our day, well, that also would lead us to overconfidence in our salvation, and thus we'd neglect our salvation from a different direction. And so actually not knowing the exact ratios has a kind of beneficial effect, in that it encourages us to neither despair nor be overconfident, but to, as Paul says, work out our salvation with fear and trembling.
Very good. And of course, Jimmy, as you know well, God gives the grace of salvation to everyone, so we can hope and pray that everyone would respond.
Yeah, he gives the grace to be saved to everyone.
Saved, yeah.
But then whether people take it up or not is on them.
Right. Thanks, Stephen.